Welcome back. Marilyn Michaels joins us from Gunderson Health System today to talk about summer colds. Thank you so much for joining us today.
My pleasure.
So tell us, what exactly is a summer cold?
Well, it's a cold you get in the summertime. It may be slightly different viruses than you would get in the wintertime. Some of the favorites that like to circulate during the summertime are your enteroviruses and your adenovirus. And the enteroviruses are spread by contact. It's through your intestinal tract, but they will cause cold symptoms.
You know, what causes something like this? Is there a different cause for the summer colds rather than during the fall and winter?
Well, they're all pretty much spread the same way, by droplets and having contact with secretions from your upper respiratory tract. But with an enterovirus, it may also be in the stools. So if you have a sick child and you're assisting with diapering and toilet training and things like that, you may be more at risk with the spread from something like that.
Are there different ways that people can protect themselves from getting one of these?
Well, your basic infection control practices such as hand hygiene. I also like to advocate oral hygiene. It helps with relieving the symptoms, and sometimes it helps with reducing the amount of viruses in your upper respiratory tract. The nasal sprays may also help with reducing the amount of stuffiness that the child may feel or you may feel, and help reduce some of the swelling and moisten some of the secretions.
And you know, this is different than allergies, and how would you treat something like this, correct?
It is different than allergies. Allergies tend to last a little longer, and they may coincide with some of your pollen counts that you see broadcasted here on your station. Where a cold, you'll peak in a day or two, and then you'll start to feel better, and they tend to last for about a week. But after maybe 3 or 4 days, you'll start to feel a lot better.
All right, thank you so much for the great information.